This is News Channel 18's Friday Night Frenzy.
Welcome back to the Friday Night Frenzy.
Sports Team 18's Caleb Martin joins us live to fill us in on how a couple of more sectional semifinal games went. Hey, Caleb.
Hey, Ross, and I appreciate that. The Fountain Central Mustangs were looking to take one step closer to winning their second straight sectional title with a win over North Vermillion tonight. The Mustangs would jump out to an early lead in this one. First quarter, Eli Moore is going to take the handoff here on this play, and he busts his way across the goal line there for the score. Extra point would be blocked, though, making it 6-0 Mustangs. On the ensuing kickoff, Jacob Harrison will make the nice return here for the Falcons, shaking off a couple tacklers as he takes it out to midfield. Same drive now, Dalton McCool connects with Lane Clark along the sidelines. That would be a first down for North Vermillion. Then it's going to be McCool again finding Clark. That would also move the chains, but the Falcons wouldn't convert it into any points. Mustangs back on offense now. Andrew Mitchell is going to hit Michael Duane on the quick strike here. He turns it up the sidelines for the big gain there. That would be a first down for the Mustangs. Then later in that drive, it's going to be Mitchell tossing it off to Eli Moore once again. He is going to bounce it out to the left here on this play, and he is gone. Touchdown, FC. Mustangs take the 18-0 lead as they go on to blow out North Vermillion tonight, 59-6. The Mustangs improve to 10-1 on the season. In Attica tonight, the Red Ramblers played host to the Rockville Rocks this evening. Attica would lead 22-19 at half. Third quarter, Mark Dobbles picks off Eric Lear's pass there. He returns it into Rockville territory, but they wouldn't convert the turnover into points. Later in the third now, Attica's Jarrett Smart rumbles his way into the end zone there. Touchdown, Red Ramblers. They take the 28-19 lead. Rockville answers right back, though. Lear connects with Joel Wittenmeyer for the score there. Extra point is good. Rockville pulls within two now, 28-26. Later on, Lear is going to hit Wittenmeyer again on the quick strike here. That would move the chains to be a first down for the Rocks. Same drive now, Tyler Bradburn, he's going to take the handoff here on this play. And let's just say it's like he's shot out of a cannon. He goes untouched for the touchdown. Rockville takes the lead 33-28, and they wouldn't look back as Rockville rallies back in this one to beat Attica 43-28. Rockville will face Fountain Central next week for the championship. Now, the Red Ramblers played a tough game tonight, but just fell a little short. They end their season with a record of 6-5. Mike and Ross, I'll send it back over to you.
All right. Thanks, as always, Caleb Martin. That's Ross Coleman reporting. All right, time to get back to more highlights. They had the cannon good and ready for tonight's game at Pioneer between the Panthers and Carroll, but the cannon took the night off, but the Pioneer football team did not. First quarter, Daniel Huckstep airs it out. Tyler Miller of the Panthers intercepts the ball. That interception led to this nice short yardage touchdown run by Austin Runyon. Second quarter, Pioneer using some option. They get it to Nate Grigsby. This guy's a good player. Gets away down the sideline, and that is a long, long touchdown run for the Panthers. We told you who was going on to win this game when we talked to Kevin O'Shea earlier. Panthers continue to roll. Speaking of Nate Grigsby, they hand it off to him often, as they do here. Winds through the defense for a rushing score. Second-rate Panthers win big by a final of 59-0. So Pioneer will take on top-ranked Central Catholic next Friday in the sectional finals. Ross?
The million-dollar question was Felix the Cat in the house for Logan Sport, and he sure was. Second quarter, Barry's driving. Tyler Hess airs it out to Victor Silva, and that is a first down. Later in the drive, Hess can't handle the snap, and South Bend Clay would get the ball on the fumble. Clay would not score, but they forced Logan Sport to punt on their next possession. Andrew Klimek blocked the punt, caught it in the air, and he returned it for a collineal touchdown. Special teams would haunt the Berries again as Clay gets a big play to start the second half. Tony Sheed takes a kickoff and returns it 89 yards for the touchdown. Nobody is catching him. The Berries advance next week's sectional championship game. The Berries end their season with a 6-5 record. We've got plenty more to come on tonight's edition of the Friday Night Frenzy.
We will update you on Purdue Volleyball's road match against the Ohio State Buckeyes, and we will get to more sectional football, including the Mounties of Southmont taking on Indianapolis Chittard. We'll be right back.